Hello friends and welcome to YouTube channel Freedom Tech. And in this session, what we are going to learn? In this session, we are going to see how to make our Raspberry Pi 4 as a USB hub. It means we can access the USB devices over the Wi-Fi, or we can say over the network, with the help of Raspberry Pi 4. Okay, so we are going to configure here a USB server. Okay, so before we move to our practical, friends, if you learn something from our videos, please consider to subscribe our channel. Okay friends, thank you so much and let's get started. So friends, first thing first you need to install the latest Raspbian OS on your Raspberry Pi 4. If you don't know how to install, I have already created the video, watch the video and just install latest Raspbian OS Bullseye on your Raspberry Pi 4. Okay, so let's start. As I told you, we are going to configure our Raspberry Pi 4 as our USB device. Okay, also I have connect here as per this tutorial I have connect here my 4GB USB device, USB pen drive. Okay, as you can see, this is what the USB pen drive which I have connect with the Raspberry Pi 4. Okay, now we are going to configure our Raspberry Pi 4 as a server. So simply I'm going to open Chromium browser, and this is what the website, virtualhere.com. I will mention the link. You need to simply click on the link, then it will open their official website, which is the virtualhere.com. Then, as I told you, we are going to configure our Raspberry Pi 4 as a USB server. So simply we need to go inside the USB server section. Okay, right now I am USB server section. Then we need to configure a Raspberry Pi 4. So of course it is the basically Linux machine, so Linux USB server, click on Linux USB server, then simply scroll down and we are basically on ARM architecture, which is the Raspberry Pi 4 of course. So we are going to download the ARM package. As you can see, virtual here USB server for Linux ARM RPi 2, 3, 4. Okay, so simply click on here. Okay, and right click, and we need to copy the link address. Okay, as I told you, again I am going to explain here, we need to simply select the virtual here USB server for Linux ARM, simply right click, copy the link address, and we need to open the terminal. Okay, then we are going to simply download the package. So sudo wget and paste that link. Okay, paste it and just hit enter. It will download the file. Okay, as you can see, vhusbdarm, that's it. We have successfully downloaded the file. Ls, as you can see, this is what the bash script. Okay, this is what the script. Now simply we need to give the full permission. So command is sudo chmod 775 and mention the file name. As you can see, this is what the file name. Simply hit enter. Okay, ls, as you can see, it basically green means we have successfully give the full permission. Now clear the screen and we are ready. We are going to first start with the help command for checking all the options. Okay, so sudo dot slash, this is what how we run the bash script, then hyphen hyphen help and just hit enter. And as you can see, this is what the option which basically we can use with the command. So minus b, or we can say hyphen b for run as a daemon in the background. Okay, so simply we are going to run the server as a background. So simply we are going to run the command like this way, sudo dot slash, then the file name bash script, and then hyphen b, that's it, hit enter. We are basically successfully running our server on Raspberry Pi 4. Now we are going to move on our Windows machine. I'm going to minimize the VNC server. Okay, click on OK. I'm going to minimize the VNC server, that's it. Now we are on our Windows machine. Simply open the Chrome browser, and again here we need to also visit their official website. Okay, and this time, because of we are going to configure our Windows machine as a client, we need to download the client software. So visit the client section, scroll down, and of course the software available for Windows, Mac OS and Linux. So right now we are on Windows machine 64-bit Windows 10. So virtual here client for Windows 10, as you can see, 64-bit. Simply click on here and it will download the software.exe file. As you can see, I have already downloaded, that's why it's come with the one, because I have already downloaded the software file. Okay, then simply open the download folder, and you need to search your software file. Okay, as you can see, this is what my software file. Simply click on it and that's it. As you can see, we have successfully opened the window, and as you can see, we don't want to do anything, it is automatically says that we have here a Raspberry Pi hub, and this is what, as you can see, mass storage device. This is what my 4GB pen drive, USB drive, which right now I am accessing over the network. Okay, so friends, now simply we need to click a right click here, and as you can see, use device option. If I click here, I can access my USB pen drive over the network on Windows machine. But first thing I want to show you here, right now I have only C drive and D drive. Okay, we have only here a two drive. Now I am going to access my USB device, USB pen drive over the network on the Windows machine. So simply right click, use this device, and we are ready. As you can see, MOS storage device is used by you. As you can see, we have now USB drive F is also available. If I go here, and this is what my pen drive, as you can see, and inside that I have created a simple text file. So this is how you can say, this is how you can make your Raspberry Pi 4 as a USB Wi-Fi hub device or USB Wi-Fi hub server. Okay, so simply if you want to stop the device, simply go here, right click, stop using this device, and that's it. If I now open the file manager, as you can see here, and as you can see here, we have right now only C and D drive. Okay, because we just stop the mass storage device. Okay, so this is how you can configure Raspberry Pi 4 as a USB hub server. Okay, so we will meet our next video. Till then, thank you, take care, and bye bye.